the nice thing about the one-year twins mission is it brings a lot of high-quality researchers together to look at a very specific problem. It gives us an opportunity to look at the human body in a very detailed fashion that we haven't done before. We're also now looking at this vision impairment syndrome. It's hypothesized to be secondary or as a result of this headward fluid shift that crew members experienced during spaceflight. So we're looking not just at the cardiovascular system in our laboratory, but we're also now looking at the eye itself, how it changes in its structure and its function. There's a strong cardiovascular component, so how much of the blood and the blood pressure gets transmitted to the head, which would be different than what's on the ground. The person that goes to see their doctor every day will have a potential benefit from what we learn in looking at our astronauts. Some of the issues that we're looking at for the one-year mission are things that people would normally experience on Earth. These sorts of physiologic changes or adaptations that we've observed or and are observing now are ones that we would expect for people who are on for 6 month transit mission to Mars. So we always stay busy. We always try and keep asking new questions, things that we think will benefit both our crew members as well as the general public.
Subscribe for more space.